they did to your temple. I don't know. Jesus ain't going to no church when he walked the face of the earth. Jesus went into a temple. Right there, if I was, I just say, hold up, hell, what the hell's going on? Wait a minute. Whoa, 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 whoa. How we go from temple to church? Let's talk about it. How you go from temple to church? No. How do we go from temple to church? Okay. You keep on following the devil where he wants you to go. You keep on following where he wants you to go. I'm not going there no more. I've been there most of my life. I'm going to make conscious decisions about my spirituality, about my relationship with Yahweh. And if I have to base it on the Bible that I have, then I'm going to go with what's true. I'm going to go with what's true. But what I know is that there's people in the book of Psalms 83 that conspire to make you forget who you are as a nation, all your holidays, all your feasts in Christ, and in God. Because yes, the people of the Bible celebrated a lot. We not exempt from that. But if we follow the right holidays and celebrate the right holidays, we'll have better outcomes and better experiences with God. But we've been thrown in the mix. Some seduction and seducing and some old wickedness been thrown in our mix. And one of the greatest things is Christianity. And I'm going to come out and say it. One of the greatest things is Christianity. Christianity has been bestowed upon us forcefully. But see, if there was any real good people, I say like this to you, Pope. You could have asked me my permission if I wanted to serve Satan, Santa Claus, Satan Claus, saints, whoever, Peter, Paul, whatever. I told you hell no. I did the research on them like I did on Jesus, because all I knew was Jesus. Then like I did on Black Jesus, now like I'm doing on Yeshua. Really the same people, but when you get to know them by their right name, you're like, oh, now they're starting to line up and fit. This makes a little bit more sense. Because you look at it, Yahweh, Yeshua, God, Jesus. Go ahead with that mess. Go ahead. You telling me he's the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Then I'd like to say Yeshua, Yahweh, Yeshua. Sounds like they come from the same person to me. God and Jesus just seem like they're totally too far apart. I wouldn't care. Don't sound nothing like nothing. Don't sound like it's really any connection. Sound like Jesus can be a God by himself. Sound like God is God by himself. But when you say Yeshua and Yahweh, you say, oh, there's a connection there. Oh, I feel it in my, yes, I feel it in my spirit. One and the same, Son of God. That makes more sense to me than God and Jesus. You're just fishing right there. You're trying to make something work. And they gave it to it, and it does work. It does work. Because what you believe, it works. If you believe it, it does work. But then the truth shall set you free. Working for you and being set free is totally two different things. Totally two different things. I'm going to give you 3 more minutes and I'm out of here. But it's totally two different things. Again, the real name of Santa is Satan. They just changed the N and flipped it over here. Mm-hmm. It is. You can sit there and be like, oh, no, 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 no. You know what? When it comes to religion, when it comes to God's word, it's all about words. God sent Jesus here to speak some words. Was his words manipulated too? Was his words maneuvered over? They had the Bible for, just say, 300 years, 350 years. Before we even got it. Okay, slavery. I'm in 1611. We in 2007. I'm in 1640. We in 2017. Well, alright. Let's just say round it. So 450 years. 500 years. We have the Bible about 150 years. They had it the remaining time. Do you know, in the same Bible, well after Jesus left the face of the earth, they put more commandments in the Bible. But they told you, oh, Jesus is the new commandment. Jesus is the new covenant. So who is they to give out any more rules behind what Jesus came and laid down the foundation? I thought he was the one who said, on all the prophets hang the law. We're not doing away with the law, but I'm here to fulfill the law. So if Christ came to fulfill the law, who is anybody else to try to correct us and make us new commandments to follow? When God already gave us commandments, Jesus gave us commandments, and who is Peter, Paul, and Mary? I'm only joking. Mary ain't had nothing to do with this, even though I know Mary Magdalene is special in Christ's heart, had a deep connection relationship with Jesus. But Peter, Paul, who's to say we need Peter and Paul's message? But I'm glad it's there, because it's the New Testament. You can go old, new, be like, whoa, God, hold up. A lot of this changed after Jesus came. Why? Because they want you to believe that Jesus is the way. Jesus is the way. Jesus is the door of the sheep. Jesus is the way to God, but Jesus isn't God. Once you get to Jesus, Jesus had to worship God. Jesus had to pray to God. Jesus had to thank God. That's all I'm trying to say about Jesus. He exists as Christ. He came to deliver people at that point in time. That's all God. Anytime God delivered, sent somebody, it was to deliver people from bondage, from oppression, from blind eyes, from deaf ears. Not everybody had to spit on the ground. Some were born from birth with blindness. Some sin caused them to be blind. But really, it was just the scale over people's eyes. A spirit of sleep, slumber, the Bible says, of deafness. That's when he came to deal with people. Those is the miracles he really did, was the spirit of the Lord. Isaiah 61. What did Jesus read from in the temple? Jesus read from Isaiah 61. He read the Old Testament. He didn't read no New Testament. Hell, New Testament ain't even exist when he was on the face of the earth. That all started after he left. That all started after the fact. Jesus said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me to set the captive free. You think everybody was in prison? Or captive in their mind, captive in their heart, captive in their soul, captive in the ways they was living, captive in the way they were serving other gods? Those are the real miracles. If somebody was oppressed, you gotta figure from Isaiah to Jesus, about 700 some years. And if Jesus had to come and set those captives free who have been walking around serving other gods longer than you and I, serving Santas and all these other guys we're gonna talk about, Satan Claus. I said Satan Claus. It is not Santa Claus. Look how long we've been walking around serving Satan Claus. And then people have been walking around serving the Roman gods and the Grecian empires and all these other peoples and the Balaks and the Balaams and the Jezebels. And oh my God, by the time Jesus comes, they so thick under their trance. They so thick under their customs of living, culture, tradition that ain't even theirs. But they lived it so much, they adapted to their culture. And we brought it over here to America, and they gave us more of their culture, and we just culturized by the European white man, the Romans, The ones who give you Satan to set the worship on Christ's birthday. Oh,